The average family of four loses around $1,800 a year in spoiled and wasted food.
So that means it's $150 per month for a family that just gets thrown away in the garbage can or down the garbage disposal.
To put some of that money back into your bank and more food into your belly, Jaden Hare, founder of SteamyKitchen.com, has three tips on how to do it with meal planning in reverse. For starters, organize your fridge, freezer, and pantry.
I started pulling everything out of the shelves, cleaning everything, and then realizing how much food has actually expired.
Also, look for the duplicate products and things your family doesn't ever use.
There were cans of food that I had for years, and in my refrigerator, I had three jars of mustard. The same exact mustard.
Try to donate the unused items.
It sounds like a daunting task, and it is. You will invest some time doing this, but at the end of it, it feels so good.
Next, take inventory.
It's fun to sit down with your family and take inventory of also what their favorite foods are, and put that on your list because that will get eaten.
This helps your pocketbook and reduces waste.
Sometimes you don't realize that the hummus that you keep buying, that you keep tossing, nobody wants to eat it anymore.
Then create zones in your fridge, freezer, and pantry dedicated to different items and label them, including any expiration dates.
So that in an instant you can see when you need to use an ingredient by, and that helps with preventing food waste.
Finally, plan recipes around what you have.
Let's start with food that you already have in your refrigerator, your freezer, and your pantry. Because let's face it, you've already spent the money.
Find recipes that can work with ingredients you typically have.
Rice bowls or tacos, you can use leftover ground beef, chicken, you can use leftover steak.
This doesn't mean you can't try new dishes. Just work with what you've got.
And then supplementing with store-bought items. Be a little bit more mindful of when you go to the grocery store and only buying what you think you'll be able to eat in this short period of time.
That's one small step forward for meal planning in reverse.